One of the phrases I've heard most in my high school career is, "You're old for your age." Time after time, I've been put into situations that require me to act mature for my age. This results in people mistaking my age for that above the legal drinking age. All my life, I've had friends older than me, and I've been told many times that I was born a generation later, that I'm an old soul in a young body, because I only have a handful of friends that are anywhere near my age. The first awkward incident occurred at the end of my sophomore year in high school. An old family friend, Valeria, who had been my camp counselor when I was younger, had invited me to dinner to catch up. It was just supposed to be the two of us getting a bite to eat. She picked me up around 7 and we went to a place called the Burger and Beer Joint on the beach. Up until then, I hadn't spent too much time in the beach area, so I was already feeling cool. While at dinner, her friend, another former camp counselor of mine, called and after hearing we were having dinner, asked to join us, and we were happy to say yes. All of a sudden, she shows up with her sister and some of their friends, and my quiet dinner with Valeria turned into a merging of more tables and chairs to accommodate 5 more guests. After we had finally settled in, the conversation took off in different directions, none of which I had any knowledge of. All night, I tried to keep up, laughing when the others did, nodding my head as if I understood the topic at hand, and trying not to draw too much attention to myself, because in truth, I had no idea what they were talking about, and staying quiet seemed like a better idea than opening my mouth and saying something stupid or, worse, childish. As the night progressed, I kept looking up at my watch, thinking of my curfew. At about 11:30, I excused myself to the restroom, because in reality, I needed to call my mom and beg her to let me stay longer. Her mortifying response was, "Fine, but I have to speak to one of the adults there." I was mortified as I silently imagined what it would be like to go back to the table and ask for one of them to talk to my mother and soothe her worries. I cringed at the thought as I began to plead with her to trust me enough to stay out of trouble and not assign a chaperone. Eventually, she agreed. As I headed back to the table, I saw that the waiter was bringing a pitcher of beer to the table. One of the guests at my table took on the task of serving everybody a glass, including me. Great, I thought. How am I going to explain my not drinking? When my glass was passed to me, I awkwardly declined, and at that moment, the conversation stopped. They looked and said, "Oh no, don't tell us you don't drink." And then the moment I had been avoiding all night, when my friend Valeria comically stated, "Huh, no, she's in high school." At that moment, everything changed. I watched in slow motion as everyone's mouth dropped and their eyes focused on my blushing and very embarrassed face. Now the conversation was focused on my age. They automatically assumed I was an 18-year-old senior, but when told I was only a 16-year-old sophomore, they were dumbfounded. They apologized for the mature conversation they had had and made comments like, "She's just a baby," and "Don't say that in front of the kid." I was humiliated and realized that if I were to continue hanging out with older friends, I'd have to accept the embarrassment that came with the discovery of my age. As time went on, the conversation would come up again and again, and I just learned to better handle it and make sure that nobody dwelled on it too long. It's hard sometimes because no matter how mature I may act, I can't change my age, and that means I can't go to places that require patrons to be 21 or older. Whether it's Cine Bistro or the Hard Rock, to society, I'm still considered a child. Being from another generation also affects the conversation. Movies, actors, events in life differ from one generation to the next, and things that they bring up are sometimes before my time. Recently, there was an incident where a fellow coworker at my internship commented on my friend Renee's jacket, calling it a members-only jacket. The people we were with started to laugh, so as to not look like an idiot, I laughed as well, even though I didn't get the joke. Later in the day, Renee started laughing, remembering the joke, and she looked at me and said, "Do you even know what a members-only jacket is?" I shyly told her that no, I had no idea what it was, and she thought that was the funniest thing in the world. Hoping she'd forget about it, I continued on with my day. Later on, I received an email. The title of that email was "Members Only Reference." I opened it to find a huge picture of Justin Bieber wearing a Members Only jacket, specifically chosen because he is of my generation. Ironically enough, I found Bieber to be too young for me in my generation. Thankfully, friends like Valeria and Renee don't hold it against me, and it's nice to know that they're always looking out for me, since at the age of 36, Renee could be my mom. The last couple of years have been quite entertaining, and for the most part, my age hasn't gotten in the way of my being able to hang out with friends. It's just kept me from certain activities. At the end of the day, I realized that sometimes in life, you just have to deal the hand you're given, and in my case, I get to do it with older friends and a nice tall glass of grape juice.